Welcome back to our channel, friends. This is Sonia here, and today we are going to create a beautiful and one of my favorite and one of the layouts which is absolutely close to my heart. So yesterday we are going to make an art journal, and this layout is absolutely amazing and I totally loved making this one. Now, to prep up my base here, I'm using an heavy gesso, the white gesso on my journal. This is actually a sketchbook which I have been using this for my journal work, and I absolutely love this one, and this is really fun to make. So here I have applied my gesso, and now I am going to give a coat of Mod Podge to the image which I am going to use. Now this is a Google printout which I took out. I did the fuzzy cutting work, and now I am applying my one coat of Mod Podge. And yes, this was a little delicate and I had to be a little very careful with this one. So I just kept that aside to dry out, and now I have already decided on which stencils I will be using. So here I have my Mate modeling paste, and I'm going to use this. So in this video, I am going to use three different stencils for the texture work. Now this one had a very broader floral pattern which I really loved to have on my bottom portion of the base. So here I'm using my modeling paste, and likewise I will be using two more different mediums here too. Now as and when required, we will be using our heat gun to speed up the drying process. This is going to make sure that when we are doing the second layer of work, it does not get smudged, and this also makes your work very faster. Now once I'm happy with the first layer of my modeling paste, then I'm going to add this brick pattern here. And yes, Tim Holtz are one of my favorite brands, and these stencils, I have been using this for like 2-3 years or 4 years, I don't even remember, and they are absolutely as it is to use. So yeah, these are one of my favorite, and these are so versatile design that you can use these kind of stencils with this pattern, the stencils with any kind of your project. Now this particular stencil is one of my favorite, which I have used on so many things. I don't even remember that. And Believe You Can is something which I really believe on. And yeah, that's the reason I thought of using this one again on another layout. And yes, this worked really well. Now I'm going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process again. If you don't have a heat gun, you can just let it dry for some time, but then again, then that process is going to be very longer. So if you are a mixed media artist or a decoupage, and if you want to try out with your different layouts, of course you need to have a very quick time to speed up the drying process. So here I have taken a blue color shade of chalk paint, and yes, like I always say, that there is no compulsion that you have to use this particular colors or that one. Of course, each colors have their own pros and cons, but I believe in using all the mediums when it comes to mixed media, and I think that's the true sense of doing a mixed media when you are blending so many colors. So here in this layout, you will see me using my chalk paints, my acrylic colors, and yes, they look absolutely gorgeous. At the end, you will even see me doing the watercolor pencil, and yeah, I absolutely love doing this one. Now here I'm using my acrylic orange color, and as you know that I love color blending, and this looks gorgeous with my layouts. So here I'm doing the broader portion with the orange color, and of course I'm going to blend this one to my brick pattern too. I always try to dilute my colors because I love playing with the lighter shades of the color. Of course at the time I need to add the shadows, the darkish color to my layouts, but I usually prefer to dilute my colors and then play around with it. Now it's time to stick up my pretty lady, and I absolutely love this one. I really don't know like this is whose art picture, but I absolutely love this one. Like the Indian lady in a sari is one of the prettiest picture what you can imagine of us. So yes, here I have sticked this with my Mod Podge, and like I said, I am going to do this video with a very basic supply. So Mod Podge is something which we generally use for decoupage work. So yes, if you have ever tried the decoupage, this is something which is going to be there with you. Now with a flat brush, I am trying to stick this really well, and this is a very important step. if you do not stick your images properly, then it is going to come out as in the mixed media, we end up playing with so many shades there. Now, of course, we need to blend the picture with the base. So for that, I'm going to use some of the very beautiful shades. So you can mix it out. Like here, I'm using the red, the green, and I will be adding grayish also. So the color choice is completely yours. Here, my pretty lady is in the maroon and a black sari. So that's the reason I'm taking something similar colors, and I'm going to blend this on my background. I usually love using round brushes whenever I am doing the color blending technique. So yes, the massive brush is something which I absolutely love using. So yes, this color blending process is going to take time. Why? Because we have so much to color and we have so much to highlight. So now, as you can see here, I have already done the texture work to which I'm highlighting with my green color. Of course, I will be adding the other shades, but as and when you start adding up colors to your texture work, they highlight and they look absolutely gorgeous. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter. Okay, so here I thought that I will add some more background. So first I thought of using this floral pattern, but then I came back to this design and I absolutely loved using my yellow color to it. So this is just to make sure that our images are, whatever the image or the theme we are choosing, it has all the shades and colors matching to the background. And yes, this actually blended my background, my texture work so well. Now for this technique here, I'm using my chalk brush. This is usually used for the stencil work and this makes your work much more easier. So the shade which I had used for the chalk paint was the orange shade, and now while doing this layout, I actually realized that my page was getting fold up too much. So here I'm just using my tacky tape to stick it to the beneath page and it actually helped me. Now I'm going to take my same acrylic block. Now usually whenever I'm doing the color blending work, I take one of the acrylic blocks and I use all the shades on that. This actually helps me in just blending the colors on my block itself and then doing it directly on my layouts. So here I'm adding gray, and as you can see that I have done all my colors in the same acrylic block, and I do not wash it or clean it until I'm done with that project completely, or unless until I'm very happy with my layout. Now one of the very important technique in color blending and your layout making is to highlight the sentiments or the text what you can have or you want to add. Now here I wanted to highlight the texture work, the sentiment which I have used. Believe you can. So here what I'm doing is I'm using my black color acrylic paint and I'm just highlighting the sentiment. So what I've done is I've kept the same stencil just above my texture work, and this is just going to make sure that only my text is being highlighted. And this is something which I really love, and wherever you feel that it has not come out really well, you can always use your paint brush and do the finishing work, and they look absolutely great. So this was one of the very easy and quick way to highlight your sentiments. And every time there are chances that you might not feel like adding the additional sentiment strips, so having your highlighted texture always looks absolutely great. So yes, right now I have to blend my picture really well. So for this, I will be using the black color, the red color, the orange color, whatever is there on my palette, and I'm going to brush it around my pretty lady and I'm going to blend this color. Now for the color blending, here I'm using a round brush. If you are very comfortable with a flat brush, you can try that. But round brush always helps in blending your colors well. and you can even try using your sponge pieces. They actually also work pretty well with your color blending technique. Now just highlighting few more stuff here and there, and this looks pretty good to me. And of course I am going to just highlight more on the lady part, because my sentiments have been highlighted by the black color acrylic paint what we have done. Now finally it's time to highlight few of my triangles which is there, and I'm just using a water pencil. Yeah, these are the water based pencils, and I'm going to do this work and just highlighting the corners of my sentiment and the triangles. And with this is almost done, and yes, this gives a complete new look, a new dimension to the background work whatever you have done. So yes, I will be doing this on the floral patterns, the texture work, and on the backgrounds. And if you don't have a white color watercolor pencil, you can even use your acrylic paints. You need to dilute that and use a very thin round brush, and with that will be ready. Now for the final sealing, I am using my Mod Podge, and I'm going to apply 2 ginger score of Mod Podge. This is going to make sure that nothing changes over the time, and my layout looks absolutely as it is the way I have done it. So yes, with this my layout is done, and I really hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. I have listed down all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.